February 7th, 2015, 6:33 a.m. That's the southeastern sky there. If you look at the sky, they covered it. Most people know what I'm talking about when I say they've covered it. Those that are trying to destroy us by spraying the atmosphere with strontium, barium, aluminum, and all sorts of cocktail of poisons. They used maybe noble excuses at one time, saying it was to protect us from the sun, which gives all life on the planet. The sun is the provider of life for the universe, technically, yet they want to block it out. And if they're doing anything, they're doing more damage than not. But you look at the spray. I mean, there's a crack on my viewfinder, so if I'm not pointing to them exactly, you'll see it. But the sprays out there. Those are all chemicals. See, when I say that in the sky back there, and it looks like a cloud cover, I say chemical cloud. You can see the lines that are a little more prevalent. They don't really, what you say, dissipate. They spread out. They blend in with clouds that are actually in the sky. And they're infamous for having X's in the sky. You can see it's kind of, that one's like kind of like a makeshift X right there. But the newest sprayers are the real thin lines, and then they spread out to look like the one below it, how it's all spread out, and like that one up there even. Okay, look at that. There's another one up there. Let me see if I can get them in the underneath the line on my viewfinder, then I can zoom in on them. Well, again, like I've said many times, we've pretty much lost the skies to breathe clean, fresh air. It's a toxic environment now. This stuff, remember, it's like anything else. What goes, it comes down, what they spray up in the sky will slowly dissipate down into the ground, and it'll get rained down into the ground. It's like seeding clouds to grow things, only they're seeding clouds to kill things. And people being the number one thing that they're killing. Upper respiratory infections, lung ailments, cancers, all types of things. I had a little flock of deer out here earlier. Six of them right over in the next field, about 300 feet away, 400 feet away. And then they ran across the field there. And what they're doing is they're eating that Monsanto. That was Monsanto corn all around us. I don't know how many acres exactly, but I'm saying 150 acres or more of corn all around us. But that's a different subject. This is what I'd like for people to see. There's a full moon up there that Brandon Lee once said, how many more are you going to see of these? And I can almost say without error, probably won't see more than a dozen of those, if that many. Full moons. So, you see the chemicals in the sky. This is the 8th District of Tennessee, West Tennessee. Stephen Fincher is the representative, which has been called his office so many times to tell him about these. I even put his name in a couple videos, you know, thinking that would draw some attention. All I did was it got a few more people to watch it. But again, just by looking at how few people look at the videos, there's hardly any comments. I think I might have one or two comments on about 40 videos I've had of this. And I have more, but there's a lot of swearing on a lot of these because, again, the people that are spraying us They don't care. I mean, they say they don't know. To me, that's total bull. You don't drive a car and not know what's in your car. You especially don't fly a plane and not know what's in your cargo, in your spray, in your fuel. So when they say, well, they don't know, that's a total lie as far as I'm concerned. So it's just another one of the pathetic looking skies in this country. There are mass protests and fights for this in other countries across the globe. But not here in the United States, because they wouldn't do that to us. Home of the stupid. You know, people are actually stupid. They believe that this government wouldn't do anything to harm them. Well, they got a rude awakening coming here pretty soon. What do you think all the police against people are? What do you think about all the race baiting that they've been doing? They know what's going on. Now, I'm not talking about your senators and your representatives. I'm talking about, like, George Carlin. The late George Carlin knew. He knew what was going on. He said, we have owners. We have real owners that you'll never see. And you're never going to get anything done. They're just going to give you just enough to keep the stupid quiet. And they keep you divided into groups, into races. But, you know, there you go. That's the conditions of the sky out here. Good luck to everybody. That's all I can say. Whether you accept it or not, that's what you're going to need.